The views expressed in the following program are those of the participants and do not necessarily reflect the views of Saga 960 AM or its management.
Good afternoon and welcome back to In Focus with Annie J Koshy here on Saga 960. And you know, before we went to break, I was sharing a little bit about a dear friend of mine, someone who I have had the opportunity to work with, but she is an incredible artist, an incredible model. She's recently been featured as Loblaws' Celebrate Your Kitchen, in the Loblaws Celebrate Your Kitchen catalog as a model. She's also been in the American Girl Doll Company as Melody's mom and Body Gloves wetsuit lifestyle model. Now, Chesand Gregory calls her love for the arts her happy place. It is my pleasure to have on air with me today Chesand Gregory, who sets herself apart as being an entrepreneur. She's been featured on various platforms, but more than anything, she's this amazing, brilliant light as a mom, as a wife, as a friend, and right now working her way into becoming an author. So welcome, Chesand. I'm so happy that you're here with us.
Thank you so much, Annie, for having me.
It's a pleasure. You're welcome. It's a pleasure
Thank
to have you.
Thank you. And
so I want to talk a little bit about your journey. Let's start with your background. I know that you grew up in Jamaica and you immigrated here to Canada, but let's talk a little bit about your early life. What was Chesand like as a young girl?
As a young girl growing up, I grew up with four brothers, actually. I'm the only girl, the last one. So wow. I was kind of a tomboy, I would say. But into my teenage years, I realized being around my aunts and my cousins, I transformed into a growing lady. I became very involved into pageants and sort of something that I ended up doing for quite some time, which leads to my modeling career now in Canada.
Right. So let's talk about, it wasn't just any random pageants. Your journey into the pageant world began at a very, very young age. Let's start with, were you always as a young girl interested in modeling or interested in being in pageants, or were you pushed into that by your family, or was there someone who was a mentor or guide that helped you get into that career path? Because it's not usual for that to just happen. How did that happen for you?
I believe the models I had around me, like my aunts, they really influenced that background where I always wanted to dress up, and they always put themselves together in a really good way, not just to as a fashion show, but they always modeled that behavior that made me want to bring that forward in my own life, putting myself together as a woman, and not just any woman, but in a ladylike mean. And I thought pageant would give me this extra push to walk in that direction of bringing grace and poise to my life, and the people I meet with bringing that grace to their life as well.
What were some of the first steps that you had to do as a young pageant, young girl starting in a pageant? What age did you start at, and what were some of the first early memories of you in pageants?
Wow, this is taking me way back. I can remember being in primary school. Back in Jamaica, we call it primary school, which would be like elementary. So I would be age 10 or 11 that I can actually remember when I first did my my pageant. And I remember winning that pageant too. So I can actually vision myself doing all that. And the dress I wore was like a yellow dress. So that's a very happy moment that I can talk about now, that it's a part of my life that I'm happy to share. It's almost like a book note or a small piece of my life that makes me the person I am today.
Now, you went on to actually win pageants for Jamaica as a country as well. So it went from where you were doing it locally and for smaller organizations to actually representing Jamaica as a country. Just share with our listeners what was the highest level that you actually achieved there.
From my primary years of doing pageant, I also won my high school pageant. And I moved on to representing my parish, which is Manchester Festival Queen. I was the runner-up there on that national level for pageants. I wanted to be recognized on another level to be the queen for Jamaica, but that wasn't something that I ended up pursuing. But I also represented on a parish level, which is Manchester Festival Queen.
That's wonderful. So then your journey takes us, you and your family decided to move to Canada. Your background was in modeling. And when you arrived in Canada, you had a vision for yourself to also pursue modeling here. How did that start for you here?
Modeling started when I wanted to sign my son up for modeling. Actually, I started back in Jamaica for my younger son into baby competitions. And when I came to Canada, I realized how fluent he was at such a young age. He would just talk all the time. And I thought to myself, as a teacher, what's the best way to utilize the skills that my son now have instead of the typical way of doing speaking, clubs and all that. So I thought about something that I have a passion for, and he's also a big talker, and he also represented for my own brand in Jamaica and different baby companies there. And that's how I started when I went to the agency. My husband was there, and he's one of my biggest supporters. He's my OG, which actually those are his initials, O and G, so it works perfectly. So he actually promoted me at that spot when I went to my agent. She was surprised that I wasn't there for myself. Instead, I was there for my son. And that's how I got started. My husband started to share everything about me. He was selling me at that moment. He spoke about how well I sang, all the things that I did back in Jamaica. And my agent thought that this is the perfect place to be and to start. And even though my agent was pushing me, I knew that it was the right choice, and my husband made the right choice for me to help me to speak about something that I have a passion for.
That's wonderful. Now, as you can hear, listeners, Chesand is very communicative. She's personable. She's very, very resourceful. Now, her experience extends far beyond just the arts, the pageant world, or just being a beautiful face and a model. Chesand is actually trained and experienced as an educator across multiple levels, including secondary, elementary, and preschool. Where did your teaching career begin?
My teaching career began in Jamaica. I did my training there, and shortly after I migrated to Canada, I taught in a Montessori school for a while. And when it got difficult for my younger one and picking him up one time, I decided to make that change in my family to actually be closer to him. So this was a sacrifice I made for my family to be closer to my son and picking up my older one from school. And I transformed into a preschool teacher, where I was able to open the door and I could see my son and I was able to pick him up on time. It was a really good feeling of being that mom and the wife and doing something that I still had a passion for, which is teaching, even though it was at a younger level for different learners. So that's where my teaching ended, not totally ended, but that's where I'm at right now.
Right. And I believe right now you've got two young children at home. How, as a young parent, has it been for you with the being stuck at home with COVID and the You know, it's one thing to educate our children at home, but when you have to wear all these hats, when you're a young entrepreneur, you have young children, you're trying to sustain your family, nurture them with food and a nurturing environment. How has these last 7 to 8 months been for you as an educator from home?
As an educator from home, I realized that the global pandemic, based on my reading, could be something that lasted for a while, which my husband and I, we've been talking about. So this is something that we've been preparing for. And I had to shift things around, change my schedule for my children. That was the first thing I had to implement at home, a new routine, a flexible routine, and something that would work for my family. So the first step was to organize myself with a schedule that my children would be able to adapt with. And moving from the norm, I decided I wanted this experience for my children to be one that they remember when they get older, not the experience that they were depressed or it was the worst time staying home. So I wanted to be a memory that we could cherish. And I struggled, like, what could we do? What could we do as a family? And I pulled on my innovative skills to actually start writing my own book.
Yes, and we're going to get to that in our second segment with you. Now, one of the challenges that I think parents with teenage kids, parents with young children, your entire life has become topsy-turvy and it's now scheduled around all of these Zoom calls. I'm assuming that your children are learning from home. And are homeschooling right now. And so the challenge has been how you're able to tag team in the course of a day to be able to meet your own deadlines and your requirements for your own career and where you want to go with those of being present as the educator, as the one, because young children sometimes are not able to do the online learning on their own. They require the adult's presence. Right? So how have you been able to juggle that?
I had to utilize the same strategy that I used before when the COVID pandemic started. I kept a similar schedule in that with the virtual online platform. After school hours, that's when I get my children to unwind from the screen and it will be a quiet space for me to also work. And I get my children to understand that everybody needs their own space and that time to unwind. We've been doing mindology fitness to get them to understand the importance of resting the mind. And they're able to understand that and to know that I am working on something. And this is the time for me to have some quiet time because I dedicate all the time to them from the moment they're awake until after school. I'm there for everything that they need, all their resources. I'm listening to two virtual schools, which is hard, but after school, that's so I'm able to have a balance with my own children and being a mom at the same time and the boss lady. So I do have challenges, but because I'm able to have that balance where when it's mealtime, I have my younger one play the piano and the other one is having bath time. So it creates a really relaxing space for me to work because I have that balance at home and I get my children to understand how one can cope in an environment that is calming and relaxing at the same time. And that's how I actually managed the challenges and the stress of the pandemic and getting everything done at the same time.
Well, you've done it very, very gracefully. And listeners, we've been speaking with Chesand Gregory. She is an educator, a model, an actress, and an immigrant here to our beautiful country of Canada. She and her family relocated from Jamaica here to Toronto, and she has made it her home. But not only that, she has gone on to actually reach great heights here. And she's also passed on that baton to her amazing son, who is also starting to create his own niche in the modeling world. We are going to take a short break right now. You've been tuned in to nFocus with Annie J Koshy here on Saga 960. I'm here every Saturday from 4 to 5 p.m. And if you missed my show today live, you can hear it on repeat again from 9 to 10 p.m. on Tuesdays. I'm going to take a short break and we'll be back right after these messages.
Stream us live at saga960am.ca.
And welcome back to In Focus here with Annie J. Koshy. And in studio with me today, I have Chesand Gregory. As we've heard her speak in the last segment, Chesand is a young entrepreneur. She is an artist. She is someone who enjoys and is passionate about music. And she is also a model. Chesand is also an author and is in the process of writing her book. Well, I want to talk to you, Chesand, right now about your musical journey, because you have the gift of a gorgeous voice. I had the pleasure of listening to you sing, and tell us about your musical journey before we move into your writing.
My journey in the musical direction started at a young age. Around the time I was maybe five, my mom would always take me to church, so church was a must, and I was on the choir. I started there singing each Sunday or each convention that I would attend to. I since moved on to high school as the choir leader, different platforms into my tertiary level. I led the choir, I was a secretary there, and moving into Canada, I started to sing at Cafe Mirage. So this was something that I enjoy even on a hobby level. This was something that I would do each weekend, just to go out for 2 hours and I would perform. And it's been the best time, like just spending time doing something that you have that passion to do. And that's something that I cherish to this day.
Chesand's happy place is in the arts. And as you've been hearing, she has shared several of the arts areas. And I can completely relate to her, because for me, that is my happy place as well. But now I want to move into the story of the JAG brothers. Can you tell us what JAG, J-A-G, stands for and who they are?
So the JAG brothers are actually my sons, my two boys. J is for Jalon and Jackson, and A, it stands for their initial, which is Amari and Anthony, and G is for Gregory. So they're the JAG brothers, and they always perform for me singing, and they also play the piano. So we do have some fun time as it playing the JAG brothers and mommy.
Well, you know, it's quite interesting. You're very close to the boys, and I want to take you back to a conversation that really struck a chord with you that you had with your elder son. And that conversation was something that really set your mind aflame and was the fuel to lead you to the path that you're on right now with this book. And let's share with our listeners, really, what was that question your son asked you in that conversation? And what was the impact for you as a mom?
Thank you, Annie. I just need to clarify that my older one inspired me for my first business. And regarding the question, it was my younger one.
Oh, okay.
Yes. So he asked me in early spring, will Santa wear a mask? And this question actually struck me that he asked this question in spring. It wasn't even December. So this was something that I had to ponder for a long time. And usually I'm able to answer questions on my own, but I had to turn to my husband. Luckily, working from home, I could turn to ask him, how do we answer this question that Jackson actually asked, that so many adults and people on different platforms, they're not thinking so far in advance, so far, which is Christmas. And if we talk about Santa, we know that that's around the festivities in December. And that was a question that really struck me, which led to the writing of Will Santa Wear a Mask? An Adventure with the Jag Brothers. I wanted to preserve something that my son brought up, which is a tradition. And if we talk about Santa, we know that we're talking about tradition and the belief system of children. And I wanted to be open with him and to believe in himself and look beyond just a typical question of just talking about Santa, because there's a whole lot that was being shared at that moment of opening that connection with my son and being open and sharing a different belief system that surrounds the Christmas time. And I decided to take it a bit further to have the COVID pandemic that surrounds the whole book involved in my writing as well.
What is the process of writing been? You took this idea that, you know, your son asked, your younger son asked a question. As a parent, you were stumped really on how to respond to that. And from that question stemmed a idea for a book. What has that journey been like?
The journey has been very overwhelming, but fun. I've been able to bond with my family as we listen to each section that I've been writing with the book. I've struggled in different areas because I had such a short timeline finding a publisher, understand different writing techniques as a developing writer. So those are some of the things that I struggled with, writing and producing the material on time and getting some of the big sponsors and different people involved, which I've been able to conquer. I now have Amazon on board, which is something that I have proven to be the impossible as a new writer, which I was told that certain companies, they're not able, they will respond to you in an email and maybe not, they'll say yes or no. But I had the opportunity to be on call with the PR, and she's lovely, and she guided me through the process without hesitation to have me on board and to work with me as a new writer. So those are some of the challenges which I've overcome because I've been persistent and to reach beyond the limit. Even though people would say the sky's the limit, I decided I will try. The worst thing I can hear is a no. And that's been my journey so far, working with different individuals and frontline medical practitioners, which have been guiding me towards this journey as well, putting my material together.
It's amazing. The book that Chesand is referring to is called Will Santa Wear a Mask? An Adventure with the Jag Brothers. Chesand, do you have a release date that you have in mind for it?
Currently, the process is taking a longer turnaround time. I'm hoping for November 14th, thereabout.
Wonderful. And so that date enables all of you who are listening to be able to look into getting this book, which will be available on Amazon for your young wards, because there are a lot of children out there. As an educator myself, I know that many children are more anxious about their holidays, their birthdays. There's traditional things that they would celebrate with their friends, get presents, be able to have a cake, all the things that as children we enjoyed. And for these young minds, that's what's, you know, that's what they look forward to. I recall as soon as my birthday was done, I was counting the days till Christmas happened because that was the next present time, right? And I think for kids, when they're that's how they do it. They gauge when is the next time they're going to get the cake, or when is the next time that they're going to have the time with their family in a celebratory sort of manner. And for young children, the pandemic has really, really caused a lot of havoc in their regular scheduling. And so books like this and authors and young parents like this who are able to share these experiences with their young children to be able to guide and navigate through them through this period of uncertainty are really, really helpful. I think your book, Chesand, is going to be not just about Santa. It can actually become a series. Have you thought about that?
It's a work in progress, putting a series together with the Jag brothers. Santa is the first step, which he'll be also on board with me, putting this book together and the voice behind the book as well, as we merge into different series.
Yeah, it's a wonderful thought. And where do you see this going? What is the impact you want? Is it locally here in Canada? Are we looking at just locally here in our beautiful province of Ontario? Or do you want to see this as an impact book that you want to make as a guide for parents across the globe? And what is your true message?
My true message is to instill the values of proper hand washing, all the precautions that children can take that surrounds a pandemic. That's what this book is entirely mostly focused on. Even though we're preserving the Christmas traditions, we're opening children's beliefs, sharing all those beliefs, and during that time, the pandemic was what started the book, and I want to introduce children to and continue the learning process of instilling these values of how we can stop the spread of COVID-19, which is something that I want to be on a global level, because we're all affected by the global pandemic. And I am searching right now, trying to coordinate with Lysol or other platforms that can help me to spread this message, because they're able to connect with different platforms to help me to spread this message as a young writer and an entrepreneur. That's where I see myself being on a global level, impacting children around the world, which I've brought into my own book, which is diversity and inclusion. That's something that is lacking when we look at books and read to our younger ones, which even for a coding class, which I signed my son up for, I wanted to see that diversity and all the things that were lacking that I see, what that I saw, I wanted to make a change. And the best way to start is with me. And I wanted to utilize my book as a teacher to bring all these aspects to life beyond the classroom. And learning can happen outside of the classroom, which is something that many are doing right now. Even if others are just working at home on the computer with their workplace, learning has taken a step further to move beyond the classroom or beyond the walls of a typical workspace. And I've decided to bring that forward with my book.
Wonderful. To give you a book summary, ho, 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 'tis a season to be jolly. But this year it is different, with Christmas just days away and the coronavirus still spreading worldwide. Santa has a big problem. Many people have lost their Christmas spirit and Santa's magic is fading. What will Santa do? To his surprise, special helpers arrive to motivate and support him by fulfilling Christmas wishes. Join the Jag brothers, Jolly and Jax, as they try to help save Christmas from the effects of COVID-19. Now, can the brothers restore Santa's magic in time for the big day? Well, you'll journey with them in this magical adventure to the front line of the North Pole to find out. Author Chessi Gregory has partnered with Amazon and CDC for a joint mission to ensure everybody is protected from illness by breaking the chain of infection. Chessi eyes for partnership with financial institutions to help for children and their families to mitigate any potential monetary difficulties during the holiday festivities this season. She will donate her book and proceeds acquired from the book to children's hospitals and shelters for children in Canada and Jamaica. With her partners. Now, many families have faced unprecedented financial hardship, and the best way to keep families together is to be engaged as a unit as they get financial help they need during the pandemic, while also being engaged in activities that can bring them joy. The author adds that this book is a great read for families during the upcoming holiday season. Now, preserving families' traditions, values, safety, these are paramount to Chesi and her husband. And she's really taken it a bit further to ensure that she's keeping the safety of children and families, as well as healthcare workers and first responders, in mind for all the work that they are doing around the world. Now, this book is going to be, as we mentioned, available after mid-November and should be there in time for you to be able to get a copy for your wards at Christmas time or gift to another small person later on in the month. So there you have it. We have been in discussion with Chesi Gregory, who is an artist, a model, a former pageant winner, and she is now currently an author and working towards the release of her children's book. And it was wonderful to speak with you, Chesi. Thank you so much for being here with us on In Focus with Annie J Koshy here at Saga 960. Well, we're going to take a short break right now. Stay tuned right after these messages. We're going to continue with news that's happening here in Peel Region and see what's happening with the upcoming elections happening in the U.S. as well. I will be back right after these messages.
No radio? No problem. Stream us live on Saga960am.ca.